So I've kind of coded myself into a corner here to prove a very important point, because you might be thinking to yourself, what happens if the data fails to load? Now, if we just, I'm just going to get rid of this second promise, and instead of resolving this, I'm going to reject it, and I'll just hit refresh over here, and you'll see that if we have it set up this way, absolutely nothing will happen if the data fails to load. And there's nothing you can do in your controller to grab it, because the controller will never be instantiated, your view will never load, and you're just pretty much out of luck. So what you should do is, instead of just having, when your site first loads up, you'll always want to have a controller that can handle that sort of failure. So instead of using our app controller to be the controller that gets tied to the view, we're going to rename this to a view controller. And we're going to say use the view controller whenever this is created. So we can just now, instead of having the app controller do all that work, also need to grab this one. As far as setting up the scope and whatnot, we're going to have our app controller handle the more basic stuff, like what happens when route changes fail. So we'll say app controller, I'll pass in the route scope, because this guy is going to listen for any of the events that come up to the route scope. And we'll get more into events and route scope and things like that later on, but it's good to be at least aware of what's going on. So we'll say route scope on, and the event we're going to listen for is route change error. And then we'll have a callback in here, and we'll just say failed to change routes. Now, basically what we can do now is just refresh, and it says failed to change routes. So we successfully handled this error. So this would be something like if we made an HTTP request and it failed to load, we could just reject it and send it back in, or we could do something now that this has failed. And now that we can do that, there's some other parameters you should know about. So the first one in here is just the event. We'll give you more info about the event. The second one is the previous route, the route that existed before you got to this one. And actually, I think it's current, then previous. I'll double check here in a second. And then the last one is the rejection. So if you want to pass a custom rejection message, do anything with, you know, whatever, you can just pass it through here. I can say your network is down, and then we could log out or handle that however we wanted, and we'll just say rejection, because this is just going to pass it straight through here, fire it into here, and you can handle it here. So your network is down, and let's just shorten this for brevity's sake, and let's double check the current and previous. So if we log out current, so this is right, because that's the current path we're trying to get to, and then the previous should be undefined because we didn't have a path before we got here, so we're good there. And then just to look at the event real quick before we get into other events, you can see we have route change error as the name of the event, and the other things that it passes along, like the scope, with any of the events that get fired off. So again, just to kind of recap what we did there, we refactored what we used as the app controller into a view controller, something that'll get used whenever that view is loaded. And then we created a new app controller, and we assigned it to the root element of our app, because we're going to use that to handle these kind of global things that can fail, or at least global within our module, such as a route change error. And within our route change error, we can handle it using properties from the event or the current route or the previous route. We can get more into advanced routing. to look at the differences between current and previous, or just basically just some sort of rejection object that you can handle and throw any sort of error you want to your user.